I cannot hear you.
Hold on. Look like I have to do this every time.
I cannot hear you.
Okay, you hear me now? Do you hear me now? Hello?
Hello, you there?
Do you hear me now? All right, do you hear me now?
Hear me? Yes.
All right. How I can help you, my friend? You are live on air.
Yes. Did you know that if you worship other gods beside the God of Jesus, whom Jesus called him the only true God, you will go to hell? Do you know that or not?
Let me ask you. Do you know that Jesus is the one who created the children of Adam?
He did?
Yeah. What do you think?
So you mean Jesus created human beings?
Well, this is what I'm saying.
Isn't it God who created human beings?
Well, this is what I'm saying. He's God.
But isn't Jesus a human?
Well, you tell me how Jesus is a human, but yet he can create a human.
Jesus did not create a human, did he?
Okay, well, you want to take a challenge?
You want to tell me where Jesus created a human?
But you want to take a challenge?
Challenge for what?
If Jesus, he is the one who created a human, you would accept him to be God?
No, I think there is more things about being
God. You see, but you are the one who said to me, worship God beside God. I mean, we are worshiping only one God, my friend. If we can prove that Jesus created mankind, that means Jesus is God.
No, I think there's a...
Okay, according to your religion, according to your religion, hold on.
Wait, let me say why I don't think that. Because I could imagine God giving a power to give him a power to human beings to make them create human beings.
Create a human being. Jesus created a human being. In your religion, you believe that Jesus, so you believe as a Muslim that Allah is not the only one who created the human being. So we have now Allah and Jesus, correct?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just giving you.
You see, I am saying a specific thing. I'm not saying the Quran says that Jesus is created from the mother birth. I'm saying now, is it true that Jesus created a human being? Did he create a human being?
Human being? I don't know. He created human.
Is it possible? Is it possible for you as a Muslim that someone other than Allah to create a human being?
If God gives a human being the power to create human beings, I don't see a problem. It doesn't make that person a god.
If God, he gave a human being ability to create a human being, so now we have two person creating a human being. We have God and we have Allah. So this mean that the human being kind is not created by Allah only, created by someone else too. That's what you are saying now.
No. You're saying one person or you're saying mankind?
I am making it simple. If there is someone else beside Allah creating a human being, is that would destroy all of Islam is about and all what people believe that there is one God?
No, I don't know if God would give a human being, as you're saying, Jesus to create human beings.
But this is mean all the stories of Muhammad is a lie. You know, if you Muslim, my friend, why you are afraid? Why you are afraid? I'm asking you a very simple question. According to your religion, is it possible there is someone else created a human being? Either you say yes or you say no.
I don't know. That's why I'm.
Don't tell me I don't know. A second ago you were lecturing me about worshiping God. Don't worship God beside God. Do you know you will go to hell if you don't worship God beside God? So this is the only thing you know about religion. You know only not to worship any God beside God. But when I ask you if Allah is the only creator for mankind, you don't have an answer. According to your religion, if there is someone beside Allah created a human being.
It doesn't matter. Actually.
No, it doesn't matter for me. It doesn't matter. It's not up to you. It's not up to you because we are trying to find if Jesus is God or not. So it does matter.
Do you know what God is?
You do not know what your God is. You do not know. Do you know?
Okay. I know God.
What is God?
The one who I know God who is the creator of the heavens and the earth.
Thank you very much. Okay, is your God the one who created everything in heaven, everything in earth, including a human being? Yes or no?
Yes, God is the one who started everything.
I'm not talking about the starter now. You see, you're playing games. Yes, is your God, yes, Allah, is the one who created a human being?
I am saying to you.
I'm saying to you, is Allah the one who created the human? Why do you want to answer? Either you say to me, yes, there is many creators beside Allah, or you say no, Allah is the only creator. Who is the creator in Islam for a human being?
The definition of the creator of God is the one who caused everything to begin to exist. That's who God is. Mm. Is that the God who you worship?
First of all, your God cannot create anything. I can prove it easy. Your God said to Muhammad, read it 3 times, and still Muhammad cannot read.
What has that got to do with?
Well, this is a creating somebody ability to read. Jesus, he said to the blind man, see, he saw. Jesus said to the man, he cannot walk, walk, he walk. Allah, he said to Muhammad 3 times, read, he cannot read.
Are you saying that a person, if he has miracles to do something, that makes them God?
Here we go. You are the one who said to me he is the creator, but in the same time, you are confirming that your God cannot make miracles.
No. Miracles does not.
So why he was not able? What do you mean miracle cannot make a person his God? Isn't it the Quran says that only Allah can do this and this and this and this? The Quran, my friend, look like you do not know your religion. You are a person who is trying to give it a shot. Is that the case?
No.
Now I'm asking you, be honest. Is that the case?
What?
Do you know what the Quran says about creating? Isn't it the Quran says that only Allah, He is the one who can create?
Only Allah who can create?
Hmm.
I think we're moving from the point.
We are not moving from the point. You see, you are scared. Yes. You see, because you know I am a Christian prince, so you are scared to say anything. You are terrified. You know when a Christian prince asks something, there is something going to follow, and you are terrified to say yes or no. So I'm asking you, according to your cult, the one called Islam, there is any other God beside Allah created a human being?
I don't know. If God gives a person the ability,
stop telling me God gave the ability. What does this have to do with give ability?
That's why I'm not.
There is no proof that your God can give anything to anyone. I'm asking you, according to your religion,
if there is any other one beside
Allah, He can create a human being. Either you say yes or you say no.
Well, I don't know.
You need to know. You are being a liar, yeah. Because the Quran, let me get you busted from the Quran. Isn't it the Quran? It says that it is He who created you, it is He who made you, it is He gathered you, it is He. I mean, the Quran, all of it, full of it. So suddenly you say to me, you don't know. Are you sure you don't know?
Okay, God created everything from nothing. That's who God is.
All right. So your God did not create everything from nothing. This is a lie. When your God Allah created Adam, hold on. When your God Allah created Adam, did He create him from nothing?
Why are you talking about the Quran now?
We are talking about God. You call me to ask me about God. Let us see who is God. Your God, did He create Adam from nothing, or He created him from mud?
From nothing, the mud, and then created Adam.
Mm. But He created Adam specifically from mud.
Yes.
Okay. Who else can create a human being from mud?
Why are you going to this?
I want to know who is your God. Do you worship only one person? Only you Muslim worship one creator, or you worship many creators? How many creators there is in your religion?
I began talking to you about that you worship other gods besides the God of Jesus. You know the God of Jesus, the only true God. Jesus called Him that in the Bible.
The God of Jesus, you see, the one you speak, the God of Jesus, Jesus speaking about His Father.
Yes, He called Him His God.
Okay, but Jesus, He said, because He is, you know, the Christian believe that we have a Trinity, and the Son is 100% man, 100% God. So the man Jesus, he is saying to them that it is not me who is speaking to you, it's God in me. This is your God. And this is why he said that the sky and the earth will go, but my words will not. This is why he said, I am the Alpha, I am the Omega. I am the beginning, I am the end. This is why he said, before Abraham I am. So he was saying to them, Jesus, the man in front of you, his existence have nothing to do with the existence of me as God. Because before Abraham I am. And this is what I'm saying to you. Who is the one who created, who is the one who created Adam and his children?
Wait.
Who is the one who created Adam and his children?
Wait. Jesus said in the Bible, I am going to my father and your father, my God and your God. So there is two gods. They cannot be one God.
No, my friend. But he said, but in the same time, you see, you cannot quote the Bible without quoting the rest. They asked him, why you don't show us the Father? He said, I am with you all this time. You do not know me. The one who saw me, he saw the Father. The one who saw me, he saw the Father. This is the Father you are talking about. So I and the Father, and he said, and I and the Father is one. So you don't quote a verse and you don't quote the other verses because it's a book. It's not just a sentence. I can't take for you a verse from the Quran and I can misquote it. And I say, here you go. Muhammad, he said, la ilaha, la ilaha. Okay, la ilaha, there's no God. That means Muhammad is a kafir, he's an atheist.
That's what you always do with the Quran. You quote one verse and leave the other.
That's a lie. Prove me wrong. Get me busted. Go ahead.
Okay. You've said 2 days ago that you've said that the Quran says that Jews and Christians will go to heaven.
Right.
And you leave all the other verses where it says Christians will save me. And
no, I did not leave them. I did not leave them.
Well, yeah, you did. No. You said the Quran says Christians are going to heaven.
I'm asking you, is it true that the Quran says that the Christians and the Jews and the Sabi and they will go to heaven? Yes or no? The Muslim refused to answer. I did not say the other verse doesn't say that. We did not even spoke about the other verses. Here we go. A verse in the front of us that says that those who they believe today and those who they are believing as Nasara
wait, you lied. It does not say today.
Okay, let us read together. إن الذين آمنوا والذين هادوا والنصارى والصابئين ومن آمن بالله ومن آمن whoever believe. This is about the present. Muhammad is speaking to people around him. Was Muhammad speaking to the dead or he's speaking to the one who's alive?
Read it
with me. Those who believe in the Quran and those who follow the Jewish Christian scriptures and the Christians and the Sabian and any who believe in Allah and the last day and work righteousness shall have their reward with their Lord. This is speaking about in the present. Muhammad is speaking to people in front of him. So show me the past tense. Is there any past tense here?
Good. Okay, and now based on the verse that you have read, only the verse. I'm not going to talk about anything else. Only on the verse. It says, whoever believes in Allah. Do you believe in Allah, Christian Prince?
But first of all, it doesn't say believe in. First of all, hold on. You see, hold on. No. You just let me teach you. You see, you do not know even how to read like your prophet. Listen, it says it clearly. And those who follow the Jewish Christians, he's counting believers. What kind of believers they are? Those who believe in the Quran, they are independent. It's different than those who believe in the Jewish scriptures. Correct.
Go to the other verse.
Okay, I'm showing it in the screen. I'm showing it in the screen. And then, and the Christians and the Sabian. And by the way, the Sabian don't believe in Allah. And the Christian don't believe in Allah. And the Jews don't believe in Allah.
Continue.
And any, this is additional. And any who believe in Allah.
Do you believe in Allah?
And any, he's adding more. Is he adding more? He's adding more. And any who believe in Allah and the last day. So he is counting the one who followed the Jewish scriptures. Do the Jewish scriptures worship Allah?
It's Christian Prince. Whoever believes in Allah, it means
and any. Do you know Arabic? Do you know Arabic? It says in the front of us. Here we go. In the ladina amanu wal ladina hadu wal nasara wal sabiun. Do you know what wa is harf atif? Equal to and. It's there's a conjunction here is about another group and so and and whoever believe in Allah. So he's adding and more and more. So As-Sabi'een don't believe in Allah. The Nasara don't believe in Allah. And the Jews don't believe in Allah. But he promised As-Sabi'een to go to heaven. And he promised those who believe in the Quran to go to heaven. And those who believe in Allah will go to heaven. At this moment, Muhammad was being a scam. He is trying to make everybody accept him.
You are a liar.
Well, here we go. Okay, let me ask you. Hold on. Okay. When you say to me, this is about those who believe in Allah in Muhammad time, that's mean they converted to Islam, correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay. Shall we go and read the verses? Shall we go and read the interpretation?
Yes, we can do that.
All right. Yeah, let's go to the interpretation. Chapter 2, verse number 62.
But there's also the reason of the time it was revealed.
Yeah, the time it was revealed, my friend.
And to whom it was revealed.
No problem. Are you telling me how I should write the interpretation? I will show you what interpretation is saying in front of us. What do you mean it have to be? Are you telling me how to write it? I'm not the writer. Read with me. This is the book of Asbab al-Nuzul. Which means the reason for the verses to come down. Your prophet says those who, etc., etc., etc. And then, okay, let's see, interpretation. Mujahid, who said, when Salman related to the prophet, Allah bless him and give him peace, the story of the monks, the prophet told him that they will dwell in the hellfire. Salman said, whole earth became gloomy for me. But then the verse was revealed. So Allah is correcting Muhammad. Salman was upset. You see, Muhammad is changing his mind and changing his Quran just to make Salman happy. Then this verse revealed, lure those who believe that which was revealed into you, Muhammad, and those who are the Jews. The Jews don't believe in Muhammad and never believe in Muhammad. Up to Allah saying, there shall be no fear, shall no fear come to them. Neither shall they grieve, and it was as if a mountain had lifted away from me. This is Salman al-Farisi saying that. Then he continued, load the verse, those who believe in that which was revealed into thee, Muhammad, and those who they are the Jews, was revealed about the monks, with whom Salman al-Farisi kept company. Salman was a Christian, okay, no problem. But the monks are, the monks are Christians. So Salman al-Farisi, hold on, Abdul, no, I did not misunderstand. by the way, you Muslims, you say Salman al-Farisi was a Christian. This is a false. He was a Sabian. We'll prove it. Those are Sabian monks. But let us continue, because here you see it says those who they are Jews. But Salman al-Farisi was not with the Jews. You see the Jews?
He was a Christian.
What the Jews have to do with Salman al-Farisi? Let us say he was a Christian, as you claim. So the Jews are in total disagreement with the Christians. So how Allah promised the Jews, but Salman is asking to let the Christians go to heaven?
Okay.
Let us love together. Hold on. Let us finish it in love. Was revealed about the monks. Shut up. Who was with Salman? No. When Salman went to see the Messenger of Allah, and Allah bless him and give him peace, he informed that their worship and striving. He said, O Messenger of Allah, they used to pray and fast, and they believe in you and pour witness that you will be sent as a prophet. When Salman finished that,
Let me show you the scam.
What do you want?
We finished it. Salman the Pharisee was a Christian. who was looking for the Prophet Muhammad, and he wanted to see him, to believe in him.
My friend, Salman al-Farisi was a Zaradisht. He was a fire worshipper. This is why As-Sabi'an, can you tell me why the Sabi'an are included?
Let me tell you why the word Jews are there.
Yeah, why the Sabi'an is included? Forget about the Sabi'an. No. Why the Sabi'an go to heaven?
if they accept Islam, if they accept Islam,
they did not. That's why they call Sabian. If they accept Islam, they are Muslims. We don't call them Sabian. If the Christians accept Islam, we don't call them Christian. We call them Muslims. If the Jews accept Islam, we don't call them Jews. We call them Muslims. So why the Jews, the Sabi and the Christian will go to heaven?
Let me tell you about the Jews. The Jews that will go to heaven in Islam are those who followed the prophet Moses. Those who followed Moses are called the Jews. They're Jews. Jews, yeah, they are Jews, and we consider them to be Muslims.
How you call them Jews, but they are Muslims? Why you call them Jews then?
By ethnicity, or
by what?
Yeah, because they followed. They're from the from Judah.
Okay, so but aren't you the one Jews who said to me, "I did lie when I say"? Isn't it you who said to me, "You did lie when you say that the Jews and the Christian will go to heaven"? And you said to me in different verses in the Quran, the Jews will not go to heaven. So how the Jews will go to heaven? And he says all the Jews, because the verse says the Jews. Jews, not one Jew, not two Jews, the Jews.
Wait, Jews will go to heaven are those who followed their prophets.
In the time of Muhammad, there was Jews who followed their prophet.
Yeah, those who continued under Judaism after the prophet came, they are no longer going to heaven.
All right,
because they're rejecting the final messenger.
So you are saying that Muhammad, when he came, that the Jews, they have a correct book. Their book is not corrupt. Correct, right?
That's not what I'm saying.
Did you say that? Because you say those who were following the Jewish scriptures in the time of Muhammad when he came, if they accepted Muhammad, they are going to go to heaven. That's what you are saying. But the interpretation, it doesn't say that. The interpretation is saying clearly that those are the Christians, those who they are the Sabian, those who they are the Jews, they will go to heaven.
Yes, before those who were before the Prophet Muhammad. Yes,
not before. It says those who they are. Are you saying to me before Muhammad they will believe in Muhammad? They are dead or they are alive?
No.
Are they dead or alive? When Muhammad is talking here, those people are dead or alive?
No, you have to understand the reason.
I'm asking you, are they alive or dead? Those who Muhammad is speaking of right now, are they dead or alive?
You mean the Jews and the Christians?
Yes, and the Sabian. Are they alive or dead?
Yes, those who are dead and those who believed at his time.
Okay, believe in what?
Those who believed in the prophets.
My friend, don't lie to yourself. And those who are Jews, those who they are Jews, and the Christians. Read with me. This is Tafsir Ibn Abbas. No, they don't believe in Muhammad. Read with me. This is Ibn Abbas. This is Ibn Abbas. Then he mentioned those who did not believe in Moses, or the prophet, saying, and those who are the Jews who deviated from the religion of Moses, and the Christians who became a Christian, and the Sabian, and the sect of those members, etc., etc., etc. And then so he is naming the Christians at that time as a Christians. If they believe in Muhammad, their name will be not a Christian no more. Their name will be Muslims, because you are called Nasara. This is why the Quran says that the Nasara are going to go to hell. Why he is not calling them Muslims? Because they are Nasara. But the verse we are talking about calling them still Nasara, correct?
Wait, where does it say in the Quran that today the Christians are called Nasara?
The Quran never calls us any name except Nasara. What's wrong with you?
No, it calls you the people of the book.
My friend, no, the people of the book, when you speak about the two together, you are ignorant. The people of the book is to put two religions together, which is Judaism and Christianity in the same time. There is nowhere the people of the book have nothing to do with being a Christian or a Jew. It's about being both in the same time, which means speaking about both in the same time, we use the title, the people of the book, because they have a book. This is the only two who have a book, right?
The gospel.
Okay. Yeah, chapter 2, verse number 120. Chapter 2, verse 120, it says, وَلَنْ تَرْضَ عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَا النَّصَارَى until you follow their religion, correct? Do you agree?
Okay, yeah.
Okay, that's mean they don't believe in his religion, correct?
Yes.
Okay, as long as they don't believe in religion of Muhammad, so how they will go to heaven?
As I told you, those who, the Jews and the Christians at the time of Muhammad and after him, they will not go to heaven.
No, they will go to heaven. The verse I showed you, it says that the Christian, it says the same word, the Christians, the Jews, the Sabian.
okay, those who came, those who were before the Muhammad's time, and who were at the time of Muhammad and believed in.
Okay, my friend. Okay, yeah, no problem. You see, you can play games as much as you want. But let me ask you a very simple question. Let me ask you a very simple question. Is Muhammad going to heaven? Is Muhammad going to heaven? Let us see the scam from the end. Is Muhammad himself going to heaven?
Okay, before I answer that, let me say something. Why do you take one verse? I understand it may be difficult for you. When I first have read this verse, I misunderstood it. I didn't know how to understand it. But why do you take one verse and leave out the rest?
Here we go. I showed you all, and you have no answer. You start fabricating things that's not there.
Wait, Christian Prince, if all the Quran says Jews and Christians will go to hell, why do you take this one verse and say, oh, look, the Quran?
Because Muhammad, as a scam man, in the beginning, he was trying to be nice to the Christians. He wanted them to support him. So he said to them, you can be, okay, you tell me how the Sabian, they will, let me ask you, did the people call Muhammad a Sabian?
Did they call him a Sabian?
I don't know. What do you mean you don't know?
I do not know of anyone who called.
So if we prove that Muhammad was called a Sabi, is that will prove that Muhammad was a Sabian?
No, it will not prove that he was a Sabi.
So why are they calling him a Sabi?
It doesn't prove anything. They called him many names. They called him a
man. But he agreed with it. He didn't say no. He did not say don't call me a Sabian. So why they called him a Sabian? You see, if you call me a Sabian and I'm not a Sabian, I will say to you, don't call me that.
It's irrelevant. It's irrelevant.
Okay. So why Muhammad was called a Sabian? It is. So when Muhammad, he was called a Sabian, they called him Sabian for what reason?
I don't know if that story. So
here we go. The story in front of us.
I will not.
Read with me. Now, I don't care if you will not or not. Here we go. The men of Muhammad, they were looking for water. They saw a woman. They said to her, let us take you to our messenger. She said to him, read with me carefully.
Look, that's not my method.
When he come to Mecca, someone said to him, you have become a Sabian. He said, I became a Muslim. Why the people, they were thinking that the Sabian and the Muslims are the same?
I don't know. That's why I'm not going to comment.
Okay. If I show you another hadith where it says Muhammad, he was called Sabi and he did not even reject that.
I'm not going to comment.
No, you will not comment anyway. So Muhammad at that moment, he was considering himself a Sabian. When he did not work with him with the Sabian, so he starts saying he's a Christian. When he did not work with the Christian, he starts saying I am a Jew. So Muhammad, he changed, he changed from place to place to place because he is a false man.
That's your bias, Christian Prince.
This is not my bias, my friend. Here we go. Let me ask you a question. Yeah. Muhammad was following the scriptures of the Jews and the Christians, or following the Quran?
He was following the Quran.
Okay, here we go. Get you busted again. Your prophet was not following the Jews' scriptures. He was following the Christian scriptures. Read with me. The prophet used to copy the people of the scriptures in matter which there was no order from Allah, and the people of the scriptures used to let their hair hang down, etc. So Muhammad, he used to copy from the Christians and the Jews their teaching. Why he is doing that?
Where's that from?
This is Sahih al-Bukhari. If Muhammad is a prophet and the Christians are lost and they will go to hell, and you are the one who said to me, if you don't believe in Muhammad, you are not in the right track. So Muhammad now is copying from the Christians and the Jews. Based on what? Because their book is corrupt? What?
Are corrupted.
Yeah.
But not all of it is corrupt.
Okay, how you know what is corrupt, what is not?
Whatever agrees with...
Whatever agree, it says there, it's not in his book. What do you mean it agree? It's not in his book yet. How he know it's agree? Why he don't wait for his God? Why he don't pray to Allah? How come Allah have time to send him messages about sex with his wives? Allah have time to tell him about the flying carpet. Allah have time to send him a message about the birds. Allah have time to tell him about all the fairy tale story. But when Muhammad, he needed a serious matter about religion, he have to copy from the Christians and the Jews. Why?
I have not come across this hadith, but I don't see any like huge problem with that.
Who is the one who wrote the Quran for Muhammad?
Who wrote the Quran on paper?
Who?
Are you talking about who wrote the Quran on paper?
Who wrote the Quran for Muhammad? Yes.
Oh, his companions.
Let me get you busted again, my friend.
You're trying to disprove something that is already agreed.
Here we go. Let us see. It's in front of you. This is Sahih al-Bukhari. There was a Christian who embraced Islam and read Surah Al-Baqarah and Al-Imran. He used to write the revelation for the Prophet. Do you see it, my friend?
Okay, what's yeah.
Okay, he's what? He is a Christian, right?
He converted to Islam, so he's
a okay. Well, hold on, the disaster is coming. And then it says, after he was writing for Muhammad, later on he returned to Christianity. And again, okay. he used to say, look, Muhammad knows nothing but what I have written for him. Do you see it?
Okay. Okay.
So who was the one making Quran?
The one who was Muslim.
The one who was written Quran. Know. Who is the one who is making Quran? The Quran is written by a Christian guy, and Muhammad have no idea what this guy is writing. Whatever this guy he write, Muhammad agree with it.
Wait. Are you saying the Quran, all of it, is authored by this man?
My friend, let us say only 30%. Let us say, because the chapter Al-Baqarah alone is the biggest chapter in the Quran, correct?
Look, let's say
the chapter of Al-Baqarah alone is the biggest chapter in the Quran, correct or no?
Yeah.
And Umran is a huge two. So now here it's mentioned that he at least he did two, at least. So he was the one making Quran for Muhammad, and he is witnessing that Muhammad, he know nothing of what is written there. I am the one who wrote it, and as I wish.
Hello.
Yeah. I'm here. You want to call a friend? What do you mean? You hello. I'm waiting for you. What do you want to do with this disaster?
No, it's not a disaster.
What do you mean a disaster? Muhammad, he know nothing. And Muhammad did not say this is a lie.
No, I don't know if this is about writing on paper or.
It's about writing, my friend. Don't play games. What do you mean write in paper? No, he used to write in the wall. What do you mean write in the paper? He used to write in his hand. What are you talking about? And he used to write the revelation for the prophet. Where the prophet revelation was written in his bum, in his face, in his shoulder, or in the paper.
There's many evidence about other companions.
My friend, this is Sahih al-Bukhari. Who care about the evidence that the Sahabi later, they are collecting what this guy he wrote. This guy, he made the Quran for your prophet. And he is witnessing Muhammad. He know nothing of what I wrote.
That's not true. That's
my
true.
Friend, this is Sahih al-Bukhari. This is Sahih al-Bukhari.
I'm not going to comment on that.
Each time I show you something, you said, I don't want to comment in that. I don't want to comment in that. Okay. Have you ever heard? Okay. Hold on. Have you ever? Okay. Let me ask you.
That's why I'm saying it to you in the beginning.
Muhammad, hold on. You call me to talk about God. And look, you are getting yourself busted more and more. We are digging door more. Have you ever heard about a guy? His name is Abdullah ibn Sarah, who left Islam because he noticed that Muhammad is copying him. Tabarakallahu ahsanul khaliqeen. Muhammad, he liked it. He said to him, put it there. But the guy, he said, this is what I said, not you. Muhammad, he said, fine, put it there. Allah, he sent it to me too.
Let's talk about this.
Why do you want to talk about it? Here we go. We have a collection of guys who work for Muhammad to write the scriptures, and they are the one who make the scriptures. Yes.
Yeah, okay, I'm not going to comment on that.
You cannot comment because simply you are a coward. You have no idea what to say. I mean, it's in front of you. The guy, why the guy, he left Muhammad? Because he saw that he's a scam. Read me. There was a Christian who embraced Islam And he read the Surah of Al-Baqarah and Umran, and he used to write the revelation for the Prophet later in his return. Shut up, let me read it. It's hurting you. I will hang up on you if you don't let me read it. I have to read it. Shut up. Come on.
What are you trying to prove?
I'm proving that Islam is false. The guy is saying, did your prophet say this is a lie? Did your prophet say this guy is a liar? Did your prophet say this guy is a liar, or he just shut up?
Wait, if I do not have an answer to your question, it does not mean there's no answer.
Okay, give me the answer. Search the answer. Yes. Go. Okay, no. Hang up. Search the answer and come back to me. Because each time I put you somewhere, all what you do, that your game is very simple. I don't know. I have no comment. I have no comment. Why you are calling me? You have no comment, right? Yeah, hang up. What I will do with you each time I get you busted, you say to me, I have no comment. So I have no comment too. I have no comment. Why you are keep saying to me, I have no answer? Is that a sign that you give up, or this is a disability?
No, I do not want
to. Okay, so do you agree that this is obviously?
I do not want to make up an answer.
I don't care if you make answer or not. I need an answer. You are calling me here to give me answers. So when you say to me, I don't have answer, that means you are stupid.
No, I am. Yes,
it's not my fault if you don't have an answer. And now you just show it. Now think, use your brain. What is happening here? Here we go. No, don't tell me. I do not know. This is not an excuse. I want you to tell me what's happening. Why this guy, he left Islam, and why he is saying, I am the one who wrote the Quran for Muhammad.
I can come back later with the answer.
Come back. Go ahead. Take your time. Who said you cannot come back? And what this have to do with God anyway? If I do such a thing. Yes.
You said
To answer or not? Are you going to answer or not?
I wanted to finish a topic we did not finish.
About the breastfeeding.
No.
No, this is my topic. I ask you how your prophet ordered your mother.
Did not ask me that.
I did ask you that.
It's not me, it's the other person.
Oh, other person. Okay. Well, what was the topic we talk about, me and you?
I began with saying, how do you worship the God beside the one true God, like the God of Jesus?
I ask you.
And then we.
All right. I ask you, do you have any other creator?
Wait. And then before that, you mentioned that Muslims do not like the shape God came in, like man, like we reject your God when you became a man because we do not like it. And I'm saying, if you think that's a bad thing to look at a human and say, well, God is not a human. How do you know you're not going to believe in the Antichrist as God if he claims to be? Because you believe in Jesus, even though he did not claim to be God. But this Antichrist will say, I am God. So how do you know you're not going to follow him?
Okay, let me ask you. You said I believe in Jesus. Hold on. You said I believe in Jesus, but he did not claim to be God. You are getting your prophet busted because the Quran say that the Christians say that Jesus is Allah. So why are you lying? Isn't it the Quran says that the Christians, they say that the Messiah is Allah himself?
The Quran says that Christians claim that God, that Jesus is God, but it also says the Quran says on behalf of Jesus, like Jesus said, I have never said to them that I am God. Jesus said that in the Quran, but that's
Jesus, he said that to them. Let me show you what Jesus said.
Well, I'll show you. Do you want me to show you? But that's beside the topic.
No, it's a topic. Why? You just mentioned it. Why you don't want to talk about it?
I'm asking you, how do you know you're not going to worship the Antichrist if he claims to be God?
Okay, hold on. Why your prophet, he compared between the look of Allah and the look of Antichrist if the Antichrist looked like Jesus?
Just answer my question.
I'm answering you. The Antichrist will claim to be God. I'm asking you now. The Antichrist will claim to be God, and he looked like Jesus supposedly because he's a man. So why Muhammad is afraid that you will be confused about him and you might think that he is God? He said, if you are confused about him, about who? About the Dajjal. It's not an Antichrist. This is not Antichrist. This is Al-Dajjal, Al-Masih Al-Dajjal, the false Messiah. Okay. So the false Messiah, if you are confused about him, know that your Lord is not one-eyed. Where is the confusion coming from? How you as a Muslim will be confused? And Muhammad is describing the look of a man, and he's saying at the end that the only difference between them is one eye. That's mean your God is a man.
You're adding words. He did not say that only difference.
Well,
but
here
anyway,
we go. It says here we go. Eternal friends, if you know, I'm not adding.
Anyway,
no. Anyway. Get me busted. No. Don't say anyway. Don't tell me. I don't accept that. Get me busted. It says the only difference is one eye. Don't lie. It's in front of
me. Show me what it says.
Here we go. Your prophet describing the size. Your prophet describing. Okay, hold on. If your God first is not a man, why do you will be confused about him and the man?
Don't ask me. Don't ask me. Show me where it says.
I'm showing you. He count for you the look, and then he says you should know that your Lord. After he count all the description, I am not adding. After he said all the description, said you should know. If you are confused about him, know that your Lord is not one-eyed. So the difference between them is what?
Anyway, the most important thing.
What is the difference your prophet mentioned here? What is the difference your prophet mentioned between this fat man, this fat short man, and your God? What is the difference between them?
Muslims know.
This is not the question. Answer me. What is the difference between the description of your prophet of the fat short man who have a curly hair, and Allah? Is it the only difference is one eye? Yes or no?
Okay, you think the Quran?
I am not thinking. I want an answer. Wait. You see, you Muslims are Muslims are like oil in the hand. You don't catch me. You cannot catch me, right? You cannot play that with me. I'm a Christian prince. What is the only difference your prophet he mentioned, so you will not be confused about the false Messiah and Allah? What is the only difference he mentioned?
Very easy. Just give me time to.
What is the only difference he mentioned?
Okay, I'll answer in the way I want to. Okay, so you believe that the Quran is the words of Muhammad.
Shut up. No, give me what the only difference he shut up. You are a liar. You will not answer. You are in the corner. What is the only difference between Allah look and the man, the fat man look, according to your prophet? What is the only difference?
Islam is a comprehensive religion.
See, you are a potato. Guys, you see how they are. Get lost. Get lost. Let your mom call me. I want the man of the house to call me. Islam is a comprehensive religion. If you're a prophet saying that the only difference between them is one thing, are you going to answer or we play games?
He didn't answer my question.
I want you to answer me. Why you're a prophet, he says, the only difference between them. Why the only difference? You see, you are the one who need to answer now.
Why
you're a prophet?
You're not going to worship the Antichrist.
I'm not going to worship the Antichrist. It's you Muslims. You see, your prophet is worried. Your prophet is worried that you will worship the Antichrist, not me. You're a prophet saying that you Muslims, he's worried. You're a prophet speaking to you. Muhammad here is speaking to who? He's speaking to the Abdul, who jump in the water, have dead dogs and women of blood from period, who drink camel urine. That is not me.
So listen,
you're a prophet speaking to here? You're a prophet speaking. We don't believe in the Dajjal. We don't believe in the hold on. We don't believe in this guy. Now, who is the guy who your prophet is speaking about? Is Al-Masih Al-Dajjal. Thank you very much. Speaking to who? To the Muslims. He is saying to who? To the Muslims. What he is saying that the only difference between them is one eye. Do you agree or not?
You as a Christian, you do not have a problem with God.
Answer the question. Answer the question. Answer the question. He is talking to you, not to me. We don't follow Muhammad. We don't follow Muhammad. You are a coward. You will not answer. Why you're a prophet is afraid that you will be confused between the look of Allah and the look of a normal man.
Because people like you think God
He's talking to the Muslims. He's talking to the Muslims. People like me are Christians. People like me, you are a liar. You are a potato. Let your mom call me. Go ahead. Get lost. Don't call me again. I have no time for kids. People like me. I don't believe in this garbage in the front of me. People like me. This is written for people like you. And you are a coward. You speak day and night that God is not a man, and yet your prophet comparing your God to a man, and the only difference between him and the man is one thing, the eye.